Snake, do you remember the sinking of that tanker 2 years ago?
Of course.
Terrorists blow a hole in an oil tanker full of crude barely 20 miles off the shore of Manhattan. Your classic nightmare. It didn't take long for the government to put an oil fence around the whole mess. And then that massive offshore cleanup facility went up inside.
A big shack. I hear the cleanup isn't quite over yet.
It takes time. But in the meantime, the shell's become a landmark, a symbol of environmental protection.
Teams Alpha and Bravo, deploy at the big shell as scheduled.
Approximately 6 hours ago, the big shell was seized by an armed group.
Do we have an ID?
Former members of the Navy SEAL Special Anti-Terrorist Training Squad Dead Cell. Russian private army members may also be involved. It's a highly trained group, and they have the big shell under complete control.
What makes them think they can get that much?
There was a government-sponsored tour going on at the Big Shell that day.
Hostages, huh?
A VIP from one of the major conservation groups, and one from our own government. The most important person in a sense.
The most important person?
James Johnson.
The president?
Unless the demands are met, the terrorists intend to blow the Big Shell out of the water.
And the crude will ignite, turning the Manhattan Harbor into an inferno.
That's not the worst-case scenario. If the chlorides being used to decontaminate the seawater go up with the oil, toxins containing catastrophic levels of dioxins will be released. In other words, the bay's ecosystem will be wiped out, and the sea will turn into a toxic soup for centuries, becoming the worst environmental disaster in history. You have two mission objectives. One, infiltrate the offshore decontamination facility Big Shell and safeguard the president and other hostages. And two, disarm the terrorists by any means necessary. You should know that SEAL Team 10 is also conducting a rescue operation. No. Foxhound remains a covert body. Don't alert them to your presence. That is an order.
This is Snake. I'm now inside Strut A of Shell 1.
How are things?
We're in luck. Looks like there are no sentries posted here.
What's the visibility?
The lights on the plant's struts are functioning. I won't have to use the IR goggles.
Any problems?
There was a brand new hole cut through the oil fence. There's someone else besides me that wanted to get in badly.
That's not possible.
What about SEAL Team 10?
They landed on the roof of the Big Shell as planned. And by the way, Snake, we're changing your code name for all following communication.
What's wrong with Snake?
Just a precaution. You are now designated Raiden. All right, Raiden. You've already covered infiltration and VR training.
I've completed 300 missions in VR. I feel like some kind of legendary mercenary.
Okay, we'll skip that part. Make sure nobody sees you. If you need to, contact me by codec. The frequency is 140.85. When you want to use the codec, push the codec button. When we need to reach you, contact you. The codec will beep. When you hear that noise, press the codec button. The codec's receiver directly stimulates the small bones of your ear. No one but you will be able to hear it.
All right. I'll contact you if anything changes.
First, make your way to the upper section of the Big Shell.
How do I get up to the next level?
There's an elevator at the far end of that area. Use that.
Sounds good.
Your new sneaking suit uses electrofiber technology, a byproduct of fiber optics research. The texture isn't far removed from rubber, but the material protects against a wide range of toxic substances. The suit itself has a wide array of built-in sensors. It is referred to as smart skin in military R&D. Data about damage to different regions of the body, including blood loss, is exchanged between the suit and the intravenous nanomachines to create a feedback system.
There's a lot of pressure on my torso.
Relax. The suit applies varying pressure to major internal organs to maximize performance and safeguard their functions. They call this the skull suit in Foxhound.
Skull suit? Seems appropriate somehow.
The hatch with a circular handle will open into the elevator area. Locate the hatch first.
Copy that. Moving on to main mission objectives.
E bentornati, miei cari serpentelli, in Metal Gear Solid 2. Finalmente nei panni di Raiden. Perché sì, questo ovviamente lo ricordavo, dato che è, se vogliamo, il colpone di scena incredibile della vita. Cosa vuoi?
Got your feet wet. These are the basic controls for Stroke the water, move forward by pushing the punch button. Push in that succession to swim faster. Change your heading by moving the left thumbstick. Up will take you up, down takes you lower. Left and right to face those directions. The O2 gauge will appear under your life gauge while you're underwater. The gauge corresponds to the amount of air you hold for a single deep breath. Once the O2 gauge falls to zero, the life gauge will start to drop. You need to be aware of that.
Comunque, stavo dicendo. Bentornati tutti quanti in allegrezza mentre io cerco di non affogare, forse inutilmente. Possiamo vedere anche dall'interno. Ma che bellezza. Sì. Ok, ce l'abbiamo fatta. Va bene, rimaniamo su. Quindi, come stavo dicendo, il colpone di scena, saranno passati già dei minuti da quando l'ho detto prima, è che in Metal Gear Solid 2 il protagonista non è Solid Snake, bensì Raiden. Direttamente da Mortal Kombat. No, questo è un altro Raiden. E questi sono un sacco di insetti che possiamo schiacciare. Non mi ricordo se sono importanti, ma fanno abbastanza schifo. E ditemi, solo a me questa introduzione di Raiden ha ricordato tipo tantissimo l'intro di Metal Gear Solid 1, con Snake che si avventura con la sua nuova tuta in un posto sott'acqua e accede a degli obiettivi, deve salvare persone e soprattutto deve andare avanti fino a raggiungere un ascensore. E peraltro, a quanto pare, il soprannome di Raiden, questo non lo ricordavo, era Snake prima che adesso gli dicessero di chiamarsi Raiden. Ah, e notare che non abbiamo l'arma da capriola. Abbiamo questo. What a... Sotto. Quindi, il capitolo precedente, quello dove usavamo Snake, era il vero Snake, era un'introduzione a tutto questo nuovo capitolo del gioco. E non sappiamo cosa sia successo davvero. All'improvviso ci siamo ritrovati nei panni di qualcun altro, che ha completato un sacco di missioni in realtà virtuale, ma non ha mai davvero combattuto, sembra. O almeno così ha detto. Fa strano mandare uno che non ha mai combattuto, però le missioni VR sono effettivamente simulazioni della realtà, uguali in pratica al 100% alla realtà. Quindi è come se avesse già combattuto. Peraltro le missioni VR è anche possibile giocarle dal menu. Sono in pratica dei minigiochi in cui abbiamo degli obiettivi, che possono essere di arrivare fino a un punto senza farci vedere, uccidere un sacco di guardie, eccetera eccetera. Ce ne sono svariate. Ma adesso non ci importa. Perché appunto anch'io... Ma non saltare, Raiden, non sai fare niente. Anch'io, come vi dicevo, non mi ricordo quasi niente di questo gioco. O mi ricordo l'inizio, fino a qui più o meno, cose verso la fine. E basta, quindi da ora in poi sono molto alla cieca. Le cose che vediamo qui non le so. Cosa succede? Ecco la guardia. Sembra un po' imbalordita. O stavo solo dormendo.
Colonel, I've sighted an enemy sentry. AN-94 and a Makarov. Those grenades, all his equipment, is Russian-made.
Must be a Gerlukovich man.
Gerlukovich?
A Russian private army that was in line to work with the Shadow Moses takeover group 4 years ago.
What's their stake in this one?
They must have made a deal, an arrangement with the terrorists. They've become a band of mercenaries, an army without a country.
Ad ogni modo, suppongo anche di averli già messi e spero vi ricordiate come funzionano. Ma anche in questa serie avremo le faccine di Kojima quando cominciano ad esserci spiegazioni eccessive e inutili. Perché ogni tanto veramente non smette di parlare quell'autore. Ho notato che i filmati qui sono molto più silenziosi che Metal Gear Solid 1. Eh? Oh, c'è il vero Snake. Che saliva da figo come Metal Gear Solid 1.
Colonel, there's definitely another intruder in here besides me.
That's not a possibility.
Not a team. Looks like a solo job.
One man.
We may not know who he is, but he managed to take care of every sentry in the area. They're all out cold. Whoever he is, he's got some skills.
We need to get an ID. But for now, you can take advantage of the situation and get to work. There's a terminal in front of the elevator. A node.
Did you say nerd?
Not nerd. Node.
Oh.
Use the node to gain access to the Big Shell's facilities network.
Then what?
Pull up the map of the structure. That'll let you activate the Soliton radar.
The Soliton radar? True. That radar came in useful during VR training.
A radar system uses biological magnetic fields as input. These estimated enemy positions are projected onto a map according to reference points collected via GPS signals and field personnel reports. We need to get to the map through the Big Shell's node to put this data processing to practical use. The node unit is about 3 feet high. Should be colored blue. Each area has at least one.
How do I gain access?
Just push the action button in front of the node. The nanomachines in your body will take care of the security clearance and allow you access to the node. Complete the procedure before those sentries gain consciousness. If they spot you, you won't be able to gain access for a while. Stay on guard.
Got it.
Va bene. Peraltro, io come dicevo, non ricordo tante cose, ma purtroppo ne ricordo alcune di molto rilevanti. Ma ciò in realtà mi permette, osservando il gioco, ma stai zitto, di notare cose che altrimenti non noterei e capire quanto possa essere davvero interessante a un livello più profondo questo gioco. Ah vabbè, mi hanno chiamato ma ho lasciato perdere. Ed è un peccato che si perdesse la battuta del nerd, perché in italiano hanno scritto che Raiden ha capito dodo invece di nodo, ma aveva capito nerd, cioè forse nel 2002 non era ancora un linguaggio così comune, nerd. Sì, bravo Raiden. Allora, cominciamo benissimo. Possiamo metterci il nome. Sembra abbastanza ovvio, no? Ampi? Anzi, Ampi! Perfetto. Maschio, sì. Il mio compleanno? Sì, sono nato, mi pare, nel 62. Il 10-10. Il mio gruppo sanguigno... 0. Sono italiano? No, sono giamaicano in realtà, non ve l'ho mai detto, ma è la realtà. Va bene, ok. Ah, impostiamo le opzioni. Curioso, molto curioso.
Good work, Raiden.
The radar should be functioning now.
Remember your VR training sessions. The tool is exactly the same one. It maps the terrain as well as the position of enemy personnel. The bright dot in the middle is you, Raiden.
Lo so come funziona il radar solito. L'ho usato un intero gioco. Però guardate com'è buffo il colonnello se lo guardiamo da questa angolazione. Sembra lì che spunza, ma un po' già badeato.
It's all made from currently existing technology. You won't be able to use it in an area with strong harmonic resonance, so be careful. The Big Shell's layout map should now be available after touching the pause button.
How do I save the mission data?
I've set aside a proprietary frequency for saves and an analyst to work on the data too.
Jack, is everything all right?
What are you doing here?
Jack, can you hear me?
Rose, you're not supposed to be involved. What's going on?
Jack, I'm a part of this mission.
Colonel, what the hell is going on?
Raiden, meet the mission analyst. She'll be overseeing the data saving and support.
Why her?
The Foxhound analyst that was supposed to take part in this mission was in an accident. Rosemary was brought in as a replacement.
An accident?
And according to the files, she knows you better than anybody else.
Rose may be in the service, but an intelligence analyst is no field officer.
Not to worry. She has our technical staff at her disposal.
She's never been a part of a field mission. This is insane.
I have my own reasons for selecting her for this mission, soldier.
Colonel, I fail to see...
I know your VR training performance in and out, but sometimes that's not enough. You're familiar with the Shadow Moses incident?
You know I covered it in VR.
If there's a crucial tactical detail that case taught us, it was the power of the operative's will to survive.
I was trained to fight. My personal feelings have no place in a mission.
We've learned that it doesn't work that way. And on the field, you need all the help you can get.
Jack, you're stuck with me whether you like it or not.
Rose.
You need someone to watch your back. But I have conditions that need to be met, Colonel.
What is it?
I'll perform my duties and save that mission data. But I'm aware that technically I'm not part of the mission control team. After all, I'm just a normal girl who's worried about Jack. But that means, Colonel, that I am not required to follow your orders outside of my immediate duties. Jack is not simply a field personnel for me to track. His safety comes first to me, not the mission. And because of that, I will be monitoring and keeping a record of every communication you have with him, Colonel.
Huh.
Given the circumstances, you're free to do what you see fit.
Hey, I prefer this to being kept in the dark waiting.
I'd like to make a request, if I may.
Of course.
His handle is Raiden. For the duration of the mission,
ecco.
Could you call him that?
Yes, sir. All right, Raiden. Let me know when you're ready to turn in a save. The proprietary save frequency is 140.96. I just switched frequencies. Jack?
What?
Do you know what day it is tomorrow?
Oh, santo cielo.
April 30th. Is there something special about it?
Isn't there?
I can't remember. I'm sorry.
Oh, well. I'll keep trying till I hear the answer. I'm gonna let you go now, Jack. Take care.
Che data sarà il 30 aprile? Ah! Carino! Le guardie hanno dei puntini sopra la testa. E man mano che diminuiscono capiamo che stanno per svegliare.
The enemy sentry is regaining consciousness.
Be careful, Jack.
Find somewhere to hide until the elevator arrives. You must stay out of sight.
Sì. Perché ovviamente... Beh, di razioni ne abbiamo. Binocolo, sensore, ma niente armi.
I'm under enemy fire.
Ma cosa... Ah, giusto, beh, sì. Sono state attaccate, in effetti, queste guardie. Ah, qui saremo al sicuro. Spero. Credo. Ok, l'ascensore è tornato. Però, se le guardie non si levano da qui, non è facile gestire la situazione. Va bene, stiamo pian pianino cominciando a entrare nel vivo della vicenda. Perché qui le cose, essendo Metal Gear, vanno avanti piuttosto lente. Tecnicamente adesso noi siamo sdraiati a fare niente, se ci pensate. Però, nei giochi stealth... Anche fare niente è un'attività. Il che è strano a pensarci. ma non è di questo che stiamo parlando adesso. Oh. E ora, vediamo se riusciamo a passare senza farci notare. Perché va bene stordire la gente, ma ogni tanto è carino anche non farsi notare. Adesso dalla mappa sto osservando il giro che fanno, ma ho l'impressione che dovremmo per forza stordirne una, sapete? Non vedo passaggi comodi attraverso cui passare. Perché qui non si passa. Vediamo, eh. Io provo a passare qui e a sperare che la guardia si giri dall'altra parte. Aha, ha funzionato. I'm a genius. Dai, adesso sali, vestiti e fai parte del logo di Metal Gear. Succede davvero?
The terrorists call themselves Sons of Liberty.
Sons of Liberty?
The name of their leader is Solid Snake.
Oh cielo.
The hero of Shadow Moses? So that's why you changed my code name.
Right, but he can't be the Solid Snake. He died 2 years ago on that tanker after he blew it sky high.
Hmm.
Could he have survived?
Not a chance.
Ma l'abbiamo visto salire l'ascensore.
Colonel, I'm on the roof. There are no sentries, but it would only take one to spot me in this light.
You never had daylight VR training after all. Stay extra sharp until you can find a node to log in from.
What about the commandos?
SEAL Team 10 has landed on Struts B and C.
And the President?
Seems he was spotted on Strut B.
Strut B?
Oh cielo. Quante spiegazioni ci sono in questo gioco?
Of shells 1 and 2. Each unit consists of a central core and 6 struts surrounding it.
So the whole thing is shaped like 2 hexagons connected end on end.
Exactly. And you're on the roof of Strut A, shell 1 at the moment. First, get to a node. Log into the network.
Got it.
Va bene. Abbiamo un po' di tempo per noi? Forse sì. Raccogliamo le cose in giro. Ah. Ecco una cosa che mi ricordo bene. Essendo questa una piattaforma petrolifera, è piena di gabbiani. E della loro cacca. Su cui scivoliamo. Quando vediamo la cacca di gabbiano, di piccione, di quello che è, dobbiamo per forza camminare. Ogni tanto la fanno. È possibile farcela fare addosso? Io resto un po' qui e vedo se la fanno, eh. Datemi del tempo.
Molti anni passarono.
Vabbè, lasciamo perdere. È divertente notare comunque come siamo passati dall'essere Solid Snake, il super gran figo, e non solo nel primo gioco, ma anche all'inizio di questo, al diventare Raiden. Il novellino che non vorremmo di sicuro giocare. Che accade?
Raiden, look at that wire fence. You may be able to crawl through it. Crouch down using the crawl button.
Non lo voglio sapere. Ti dicono davvero tutto, eh. Mamma mia. Mi ricorda Metal Gear Solid.
Raiden, SEAL Team 10 is in.
Do we really have no line of communication with the SEALs?
They don't know a thing about us. You know we work in the dark, and this mission is no exception. Only a few people know about your presence here. There's no need for concern. This operation is under Pentagon's direct command, and the NSDD came from the Vice President and the Secretary of Defense. Your mission may be top secret, but it's gone through the usual channels.
Va bene, quindi ovviamente siamo soli come dei cani. E non abbiamo neanche le sigarette. Che poi, fumare fa male, quindi insomma, Raiden è più furbo, è più un bravo ragazzo rispetto a Snake. E persino il suo doppiatore è più scrauso.
I'll go check the roof. I'll leave the first floor to you, okay?
Understood.
Non serve a niente, Raiden. Cosa fai? C'è il nodo.
Colonel, I've located the node, but it's under heavy surveillance.
Ma c'è un tipo, uno solo.
Distract them. Try making some noise to draw their attention away.
How?
Flatten yourself against a wall and hit the punch button.
Got it.
Ma davvero? Ok, vabbè, ha funzionato. Facciamo finta di niente. Oh, abbiamo il radar. Ma mi pare di capire che quindi non possiamo strangolare la gente. Perché se no sarebbe stato abbastanza facile farlo in realtà. Quindi mi... C'è nessuno. Cosa succede? Ah, beh. Semplice. Guardie.
Raiden, watch out. There are sentries posted on the connecting bridge. They will spot you if you continue on course.
Any recommendations?
Use the hanging mode.
Hanging?
Face any waist-high railing and push the action button to clear the railing and hang over the side. Once there, you can move sideways while keeping out of enemy sight.
All right, I'm giving it a try.
Don't forget the grip gauge. It will keep decreasing during a hanging maneuver, and once it runs out, you will fall.
Copy that.
Wait a second. I just intercepted new intelligence on the operation being executed by SEAL Team 10.
Intercepted?
As I said before, they need to be kept in the dark about our presence.
So we just listen in.
I'm patching it through.
This is Alpha Zero. We have the president.
Is he safe?
He is safe.
What about the package?
Tell the guys upstairs that we've secured the package. Easy money.
Good work. Your retrieval is on the way. Come on home.
Roger that.
Holy!
Alpha Zero, report.
Damn it, cover the president!
Come in, Alpha Zero.
This is Alpha Zero. We're under attack. This is crazy! Is that...
Alpha Zero, respond. All Alpha, respond.
Raiden, the president's life is in danger. Head to Strut B now.
Va bene, dobbiamo salvare il presidente. E... Diamine. Quanto parlano le persone qui. E mi ricordo, vedete, grip c'è anche scritto livello 1. Perché mi sembra che se rimanessimo appesi abbastanza, effettivamente potremmo migliorare. E ci aumenterebbe la barra. Però mi sembra che ci voglia veramente tantissimo. E... Beh, sei agile comunque. E Diamine Raiden, per essere uno che ha studiato, non sa un po' niente, parliamoci chiaro. Ogni cosa gliela deve dire il colonnello. Ah, ora che siamo nella zona B però non abbiamo più la mappa, no? Oh no, Grey Fox, il corridoio è uguale, però gira a destra invece che a sinistra. Beh, sì, ci assomiglia non poco. Oh no, c'è davvero un ninja! Ma serio? Giusto. Lui. È troppo veloce per voi. Beh. Se tutto ciò è molto simile a... A Shadow Moses, questo sarebbe l'equivalente di Grey Fox.
Oh no, no!
fa come balla. E come taglia i tendini con precisione chirurgica. Ok. Ma quanto sei bello. Va bene, sembra competente. A differenza di Raiden. Ha spazzato sangue in tutta la stanza. È di una stanza grossa, quindi complimenti. Sì. Sì, avete capito bene. Gli sta facendo un grosso succhiotto.
What are you?
E dove lo tieni il coltello? Allora, questi doppi sensi, vabbè, lasciamo perdere. Questi innuendo.
5 today.
Non. Sì, è un vampiro quest'uomo. E si fa i tagli per ricordare quanta gente uccide.
Get down.
E stavamo già per morire all'inizio della missione. Quest'uomo qui sarà spacciato?
Where is he?
E la voce sembra quella di Snake. Ah! Forse no. Ma spara, vai!
Strange smell. You smell like... Are you?
It has to be. Shoot him! What are you waiting for?
Sì, ma è troppo figo, Vamp.
Vamp. Yeah, Queen?
Are you all done cleaning up?
Yes, but wait till I tell you what I found.
Something interesting?
I tell you in person. Where are you?
In the central unit with the president.
Be right there.
Hold on. I'm not an enemy. Calm down.
Vediamo di capire.
My name is Plissken. Iroquois Plissken, Lieutenant Junior Grade.
Okay. Però si guarda Snake.
How did you get in?
Fast rope descent from a Navy chopper.
Però c'è insetti che ce l'hanno lì sotto.
Have I seen you before?
That suit. Are you Foxhound?
That's right.
Foxhound was disbanded.
Huh?
Where were you before Foxhound? Delta Force?
Oh no, arriva Spiegoni.
I was part of the Army's Force 21 trials.
Force 21? That's about tactical IT deployment, right? Any field experience?
No, not really.
So this is your first?
I've had extensive training, the kind that's indistinguishable from the real thing.
Like what?
Sneaking mission 60, weapons 80, advanced
VR, huh?
But realistic in every way.
A virtual grunt of the digital age, that's just great.
That's far more effective than live exercises.
You don't get injured in VR, do you? Every year, a few soldiers die in field exercises.
There's pain sensation in VR, and even a sense of reality and urgency. The only difference is it isn't actually happening.
That's the way they want you to think, to remove you from the fear that goes with battle situations. War is a video game. What better way to raise the ultimate soldier?
Un sacco di Snake. Quella è la missione VR del primo Metal Gear, peraltro.
So you're saying that VR training is some kind of mind control?
O quello sono i videogiochi.
Raiden, what's going on?
The Alpha team from Navy SEAL 10 is dead. No, a single survivor.
The kid's wired with nanomachines.
What about the president?
Looks like they took him somewhere else.
I see. You said there was a survivor from SEAL Team 10.
Yeah. Lieutenant J.G. Plissken.
Has he seen your face?
What?
This is a top secret mission. No one can know that we're involved.
It's a little too late for that.
Ma come l'hai detto, Raiden?
What's up?
Take a look.
Huh.
What the hell?
A Navy captain.
Oh no.
You all right?
Stato contagiato.
Give me a few minutes.
Dal vampirismo o dal Fox Die?
Must have lost a few more pints than I thought.
Dai, anche le sigarette.
What was that man just now?
That blood-sucking freak? That was Vamp.
Non era un Vamp, era Vamp, si chiama così.
He's Romanian, a wizard with knives, as you saw.
The way he moved didn't seem human.
You won't see that in VR, I guarantee.
What is he?
One of the members of Dead Cell.
Dead Cell? Him?
A special forces unit created by ex-president George Sears. The name was originally intended to reflect its anti-terrorist functions. The unit would launch unannounced assaults on government complexes for the ultimate terrorism simulation. They were needed to show VR troopers like you how to deal with the real thing. But around the time their original leader died in prison, the unit began to unravel. They were always close to the edge, but they became more and more extreme, began to go after US allies, even civilians. We estimate that no fewer than 100 people died as a result of accidents the Dead Cell arranged on their own. They were out of control, and it all came to a head 6 months ago.
What happened?
The unit was devastated. There are only 3 left now, and you just saw one of them.
Why would they go after the Big Shell?
How should I know? I told you they were on the lunatic fringe.
What about their leader? He says he's Solid Snake.
Snake died 2 years ago.
You mean the incident that made this Big Shell necessary in the first place?
Right, and he was the one that sank that tanker.
But he's a legend.
Legends are usually bad news. There's not a lot of difference between heroes and madmen.
You're saying Snake is still alive and pulled another one?
No, he's not involved in this one. His body was positively ID'd 2 years ago.
Snake is dead.
Ma non ci crede nessuno.
And buried.
What about the other soldiers? I saw Russian equipment too.
Former Soviet military. They're probably mercenaries. The Big Shell is too much ground for just Dead Cell members to hold down. You weren't briefed on any of this? And you came in alone to boot? Why? What are you really doing here? Can't tell me, huh? Fine with me.
I don't smoke.
Keep it anyway. May come in handy.
E lui lo sa bene.
Take this too.
Ooh.
Bravo Zero, currently at the bridge between struts B and C. The president is... Damn, I can't hit this thing. It's like some bad dream. Alpha, anyone, come in, all Alpha. This is Bravo Zero.
Aren't you going to answer him?
The BC connecting bridge.
We need to get there. Can you handle it?
I need a few more minutes. Remember my frequency. It's 141.80.
141.80. Got it.
I've been briefed on this plant's layout. If you need information on the place or about Dead Cell, contact me. You're using nano communication, right?
Yeah, but I can patch into your frequency.
Hey, what's your name?
Jack, in teoria.
Raiden.
Raiden? Strange code name.
Makes up for the boring one my parents gave me.
Maybe I'll find out someday.
Persino nel nome, Raiden è una persona molto più comune. Beh, oddio. Snake in realtà si chiama David. Scusa, ero, ti rubo qualcosa qui. Mi ricollego al nodo. E... dannazione quanto parlano! Una cosa incredibile! E io ricordavo che Metal Gear Solid 1 avesse tante cutscene e poca azione rispetto appunto alle gigantesche intense cutscene. Solo che quando è uscito Metal Gear Solid 1 era una novità. E comunque il gioco... ce n'era. Ce n'era di gioco, in poche parole. La so come, proprio quella dell'1. E... ora come ora mi sembra che questo Metal Gear Solid 2 abbia ancora aumentato la quantità di filmati. È incredibile.
Jack, it's me.
Ciao.
Everything okay, Rose?
Don't you need to save the mission data?
Oh yeah, thanks for the reminder.
Lo stavo per fare anch'io da solo, ma grazie.
Jack, do you remember what day tomorrow is?
That again. I'm sorry, but I still don't have a clue.
That's okay.
What is it, Rose? Talk to me.
I'd rather you figure it out. It's important.
How important?
Important enough. And we'll talk about it tomorrow.
Why not now?
Tomorrow seems more appropriate. I need all the help I can get so that I won't chicken out anyway.
Is that the reason you decided to be part of this mission? Okay, I'm gonna finish this thing by tomorrow no matter what.
You know I'll do everything I can to help you.
Rose, there's something I need you to do as an analyst.
What is it?
It has to do with Solid Snake. The leader of this takeover incident is claiming that he's Snake himself.
The legendary mercenary?
I need as much data on him as possible. Everything they have on him after the Shadow Moses incident.
He's dead now, isn't he?
Yes. Should be a burial record somewhere, too. You should be able to request top-level security clearance from the Colonel. That should get us into the most classified material.
I'm on it. I'll contact you as soon as I find out something.
Ok. Come stavo dicendo, ci sono così tanti filmati che in pratica ho giocato pochissimo io... ma è più o meno già ora di salutarci, perché, insomma, secondo il mio potente cronometro è già circa mezz'ora che stiamo andando avanti. Quindi, sì, insomma. Dai, andiamo avanti ancora un pochettino inoino. Se vedo che partono altri filmati, però mi fermo, perché non c'è tempo, non c'è spazio, ma nessuno capirà. Foto. La Statua della Libertà. Beh, adesso siamo, appunto, negli Stati Uniti. Ah, giusto, in Metal Gear Solid 1 invece eravamo in Alaska, mi sembra. Sì, perché alla fine c'erano anche gli animali tipici dell'Alaska. Oh no, c'è già casino, non dovevo andare avanti, ho sbagliato, ora partiamo filmato di 60 minuti. (Ride) Allora, vi ricordo ancora che di questo personaggio ne parlavo nella recensione. State a vedere. I colpi la mancano. What the hell is that? Le pallottole arrivano e fanno come le frecce della From Software, ma al contrario. Put me out of my misery.
This is impossible. Nothing will hit her. Is she the one they call Fortune?
È una persona molto fortunata. I proiettili non la colpiscono mai. E ha un'arma grossa in mano.
Gwyn.
Don't let them take the president!
Oh, ma quello è il presidente.
Ready grenades!
Ha fatto cilecca! Good. È troppo fortunata sta tizia per colpirla.
Today is another bad day. Is there anyone here that can give me happiness?
Tipo un cannone Gauss o qualcosa di simile. Ciao, ciao. No, hanno colpito un gabbiano. Sorry, my beauties. I'll see you again someday. Colpito parecchi gabbiani, continuano a cadere. Ecco, chiamo il paparino, va.
Colonel, SEAL Team 10's Bravo team was wiped out.
I see.
What happened to the cargo choppers?
Both of them are at the bottom of the harbor. Looks like your new hosts have a Harrier too.
A Harrier? What is this?
Calm down. It just means they anticipated the attack.
What?
Besides, since the SEALs drew their fire, your infiltration went off without a hitch. On top of that, we know their defensive capabilities.
Are you saying this was all a feint?
Raiden, get a hold of yourself. The entire mission is in your hands now. Do you understand?
But...
There's no time for questions. They could decide to retaliate for that failed assault.
You mean the hostages?
They could be in danger, yes. But we need to consider the possibility that they'll blow the whole shell. If that toxic spell does take place, it'll devastate not only the harbor, but poison the coastline for generations. Raiden, we've had to adjust the mission objectives. The priority is now on removing those C4s at the terrace wired over the big shell. The president can wait, but this can't.
Colonel, you know I'm no bomb disposal expert.
That's not a problem. The Bravo team brought an explosives pro in with them. He was supposed to stand by on Strut C according to their mission plan. You should find him there.
Is this according to simulation too?
What are you talking about? Get to Strut C and find him.
Understood. But I need to ask you something before I go.
Make it quick.
Who are they? Dead Cell, I mean. They couldn't hit her no matter how hard they tried. And that vampire, too, it's like being in a nightmare you can't wake up from.
Jack, snap out of it.
And you, Rose. I can't believe you're on this mission. I keep thinking I'll wake up.
Raiden, this is real. And that's why you won't wake up.
But nothing seems real.
I've made up my mind to stay with you. Whether this is real or a bad dream, I'll keep watching you till it's over.
Thank you, Rose. And I won't let you be just a dream.
Are you two done? Raiden, you're needed on Strut C.
Ok, direi che per oggi abbiamo visto quasi fin troppa roba. Di conseguenza, credo che possiamo salutarci. Sono perplesso perché ci sono tante cose che non ricordo e che quindi non capisco. Ma, come dicevo... Oh mio Dio, ma che strisciata brutta... diciamo... Stavo dicendo... Io come sempre sono Unpetrackable e... Ci vediamo... Nel futuro...